I'm here at Larry's house. We're going to pour concrete today on his garage. Larry, tell me what you've done so far with laying the rebar and the gravel here.
Well, we obviously had the foundation walls up already. This area was down pretty low. We had to put a fill of a couple of feet. It was a wasteland of bowling balls and extra concrete and chunks, and so we backfilled it with 3/4 minus rock and then plate compacted it.
And you already put your stairs in?
Yeah, we put the stairs in to make that easier to float around. And you can see the snapped lines around the perimeter of the foundation there. That's gonna be the finished elevation of the concrete floor.
How many inches of gravel did you put in here, packed gravel?
It was kind of very uneven, so in some places there's probably 10 or 12, in some places there's only 3 or 4. And then the rebar, it's 3/8, 24-inch on center, sitting a couple inches off the ground.
Any special requirements making it more for heavier trucks or anything, or is this just
no? It's not commercial. We you don't even have to put rebar in it. I like to because it's cheap insurance.
Yeah,
$160 worth of rebar, so it's not like it's a lot of money.
Okay. Well, I see you got your post in here for the saddles.
Therefore, we'll screed on those.
Hey, you are putting a slope on this?
No, I'm gonna make it flat.
You're gonna make it flat.
Yeah, some people like to put slopes on their garage, but I don't. And then this will screed across the top of this.
Only to keep a wet garage, you'd think that you'd want to do that. But if you don't keep a wet garage, there's really no reason. It looks like it's sloped here.
Yeah, it may look like it, but it's not.
It's not. All right. Tell me what we're going to do today here.
So we got a pumper truck, a line pump that's showing up probably here in a few minutes. And we ordered 8.5 yards. And the line pumper will come in, and then the concrete truck will back up against that, and then they'll pump this out with a hose, and then we'll be screeding it just as fast as they pump it.
Okay. How long will it take to pump out here?
It shouldn't take more than a half an hour.
Oh.
It goes pretty fast.
Water is first sprayed on the ground before pouring. Since concrete is porous, a dry ground can suck moisture from the concrete during curing and weaken the concrete. Larry ordered 8.5 cubic yards of concrete for his 25 by 24 foot garage floor. The concrete truck will dump the mix as needed into the pumper's hopper. The pump will then push the mix into the 3-inch diameter hose to where the concrete is needed. Hot water is added to the mix at the batch plant to speed curing in cold weather. This will cause the concrete to cure a couple of hours sooner than normal. In warmer weather, this is usually not done.
How does he know how much water to add?
It's metered right there where his hand is.
So this is hot water he's adding?
It should be, yeah.
He just knows to put a certain amount in.
Yeah.
It's not how viscous it is. He doesn't know how viscous it is or how sometimes
so he knows. I mean, that's all controlled at the factory. They got exact settings because they have. There's a lot of engineered projects where things have to be dialed in really tight.
Is this any special type of concrete?
Special mix?
Yeah.
No, other than hot water and the slump, which is how thick it is. The size of gravel, a pumper truck with only a 3-inch line here can't pump gravel beads bigger than like a 1/2 inch or 3/8. If that was a bigger pumper, you could go to bigger gravel, but it gets stuck if you get bigger than that. So I have a small gravel. Game on!
Pumping has just started. The wooden forms at the opening around the doors were sprayed with form release, which helps prevent concrete from sticking to the wood and makes it easier for removal after drying. The pouring is being divided into halves. The first half of the garage will be poured and leveled before beginning on the second half. Jesse is making sure that the concrete height is level and at the height of the blue snap lines. I am speeding up the video 3x. While the concrete is being poured, Spencer is moving it from where there's too much to areas where there's not enough with a muck rake. It costs about $1,500 for the 8.5 yards of concrete to be delivered on site. It is a 3/8 inch max stone with a 5 inch slump. The line pumping is about $400 and the flat work labor takes about 20 man hours. What we don't see in this video is the 10 yards of crushed rock gravel 3/4 inch minus that costs about $450. It was pounded and placed, and then a 3/8 inch rebar was installed on the packed rock that cost another $160. The total cost for this project and all the items are calculated at the end of this video.
How do you make sure that this rebar gets back up or it just will float back up? You just count on it to?
It's just where you want to be, just about an inch off of it. You just want concrete just to go below it.
Yeah.
It doesn't need to be in the center. In fact, you want it lower than you want higher, because if it gets too close to the surface, it will send the cracks up to the top.
They are now moving the screeding boards to other yokes as the leveling of the concrete continues. The yoke stationed on the rebar stakes are set to a height that is level to the blue snap line on the wall, thus assuring that the concrete slab will be flat and level. Jesse continues to make sure the concrete is level and at the height of the blue snap line. Job just getting completed up right now. Still have to fill in some holes where we had the pipes for the screeding. But it took about an hour and a half. Still some finishing work we have to do on this for the rest of the day. Doug is using a bull float to reach far out onto the slab without having to get on the concrete with knee boards. The purpose is to level ridges and fill voids left by the screeding operations.
See how when he rotates that, it changes the pitch?
Oh no, I didn't see that.
See, it rotated the pitch and it flops it one way versus the other. Uh-huh. So you go rotate it now. So the leading edge is.
Yeah.
Okay, where are you going there now? There you go.
Doug is now finishing the concrete by troweling with knee boards on top of the concrete. This provides a finer surface, bringing the cream to the top and flattening the surface. A second troweling will need to be done as the concrete sets up more for the final surface finishing. Tomorrow, Doug and Jesse will cut 3/8-inch grooves with a diamond saw into the concrete, both length and widthwise in the slab. This channels the cracks that would occur over time in concrete slabs larger than 10 by 10 feet.
It's pretty well set up. You can get down there with boards.
Here's the breakdown cost of the 25-foot by 24-foot garage floor. It took 620 feet of 3/8-inch rebar that cost $180, 10 yards of crushed rock gravel that cost $450, 8.5 yards of concrete for $1,550, line pump service for $400, 40 hours of total labor, including the ground prep costing about $1,400, rental of vibrating plate for $60, wood forms needed for garage door openings cost $80, and the total cost $4,120. If you enjoy, please like and subscribe for more.